Hello, everyone. Hello. My name is Jeff Van Dusen. I am the Director of Events for the National Soccer Coaches Association of America. I want to welcome you to the NSCAA Annual Convention. Thank you for braving the line for registration. If you did not register, please do so before tomorrow morning. We'll stay open tonight until 9:30. We'll reopen tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock. The reason the line was so long is we have more people at the NSCAA convention than ever before. Thank you. We also have 5 sessions tonight compared to the usual 2. So the convention is getting bigger. I think we're enhancing the event tremendously. Hopefully that you'll see it be more interactive for you and that you can engage a network like you've never done before. Thank you for being here. Another brief housekeeping note. The validations, if you're looking for CEUs and diplomas, will be behind the bleachers after each of the designated sessions. If you don't have a validation form, they will have some extra ones tonight. But if you need them in the future, you have to go to the NSCAA booth in Grand Hall. Enough of the housekeeping. I'd love to introduce the National Soccer Coaches Association of America's president, Jack Huckle.
Thank you, Jeff. Hey, welcome everybody to this opening session of the 67th annual NSCAA convention. It's a real pleasure to be here. It's great to be back among a great group of soccer coaches and soccer friends and soccer family. I'm excited about our convention, about this week. Philadelphia is always a great city, and we're going to have a great time, and I hope you do as well. Tonight, I'm pleased to present the NSCAA Director of Coaching Education, Ian Barker, and Continental FC for activities to increase speed of play and speed of thought. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you for coming. The boys tell me it's FC Continental, right? Under 18s, and my colleague Courtney, who we just were doing a premier course in Florida. So just one last time, just give it up for the boys and Courtney, if you would, please. We very much want to get to it really quickly. Appreciating a very large and diverse audience with a lot of different experiences, the hope over the next 55 minutes or so is not to necessarily give you a series of activities you've never seen before. There's a very good chance you will have seen all of these activities before. The trick will be, is there something about the way that we present them, or something about things that we pull out of this session that may be transferable to your environment? So it's a bit of an opportunity for an exploration. It's an exploration of, is there something in this 55 minutes which will be useful to you as a coach and to your players? And it will be a progressive training session, and hopefully the boys will paint some really good pictures for us. So, with no further ado, could you two guys, and you two guys, and you two guys, just go hit the sideline for a second, all right? Whoa, where are you going? Where's he going? Get that one back.
One.
Which one? Any one of them, that's good. And Courtney, encourage the boys just to sit and relax. Okay. First team to have everybody down on one knee. Why wouldn't you? First team to get everybody down on one knee. You want to get down on one knee. Okay, Orange just about won it. That was the lamest thing I've ever seen. Okay. A gray out there with the balls. A gray out there with the balls. A gray out there with the balls. 5 in here against 2. Okay, fellas, the space is the blue dots, these yellow dots. So you've got kind of a rectangle in the middle of the field. The five oranges are trying to keep the ball in the area. The two grays, you're trying to dispossess them. And if you do, and you can hit one of your three outside players, that's great. Oranges, if they dispossess you, try to get it back off them. Okay? We will keep oranges at the five and grays at the two until I tell you otherwise. Okay? And play. Okay, that's out of bounds. Leave it. We'll put the next ball in, and for now it'll be me. And we play. Okay, put a ball in there. Okay, and a ball in here. Good, and hold it there. Hold it. Hold it, stop moving. What's your name right there? Right here. Just out of curiosity, Alex, why have you decided to pop up in the middle of the grid? Why have you decided to play in the middle? Everybody else seems to want to hang out on the outsides.
Checking in to get the ball, you had no options.
Okay, checking in to get the ball, no options. Fair enough. Switch the greys real quick. So two out, two in. And it's important, I think, to make sure the boys understand the activity and the surface and the space is appropriate. I think for what I want to do, the space is appropriate. The boys have demonstrated enough ability, so I feel good about this. So we're good. Let's just keep playing five versus two, but with this caveat now. Could you, Joe, go press him a little bit. Just walk over, Grace. Walk over. I'd like to see how many times a guy could have the ball there and end up over there with the ball pretty quickly afterwards. Or if the ball was out to him, yeah, and the greys walk over, not only do we keep it, but could you end up with it back here? So I'm trying to see if we can get the oranges to move yourselves around to get behind the greys and get the ball back. All right, ball off my touch, give it to me. Live off my touch, and we play. Let's go. And can we move, Joe? Can we move, though? Good ball, well done. Interesting. Okay, heads up. We got it. And play. Can you get somewhere else with it? Okay, hold it. Give the ball back to Joe. All right, Joe, we're going to kind of walk through this with a little bit of pressure from Gray. Is that Joe? Yeah? And just get over here and get the ball back. Any way you can. Just walk it through. Go on. Give, go, you got it back on the other side. All right, give it to him. Show me another way. Come and get him, Gray, to get behind him. Show me another way. Similar, give and go, right? You show me another way. There. Oh, hello. That's interesting. All right, I like that. Sort of a little bit of an overlap in the activity. How about, come and press here. Could you hit him long and then move off the ball? Go get it, go on. All right, I'll take that. That's all right. And how about, if anybody, get the ball. And you two aren't going to tackle him. Can you beat him? Beat them one-on-one? Go on, just take him on. Just take him on. That would be fine too. So there's different ways of doing it, and you showed them to me. Can I see the ball? Now, the trick is, if you guys get that movement going and that success, you're going to all end up in the same space, unless the guy who's killing the space gets out. So I don't want to have you all on one side of the grid. You with me? And play. Let's go. Okay, good. Hold it there. What's your name?
Luke.
Drew, you went for the give and go.
Luke,
went for the give and go. You didn't give it to him because he took pressure and you got the ball free. We lost it out of bounds. So showing the willingness to move and combine will create opportunity somewhere. All right, and we play. Let's go. And play. Can you get somewhere else? Well done. Okay, and hold it there. Hold it there. We'll give it back. Can you get me a ball, Joe? Can you get me a ball? Joe, can you get me a ball? Okay, good. Not bad at all. So, unlike a traditional keep away, where we're satisfied with possession, we're going to just put this little component in of trying to go somewhere else. Now, check this out. You guys come and press a little bit. I give it there. I go. I get it back. And now what's the problem? What's the problem?
I'll still over there.
Well, you're right there, right? So as I come in here now, can you get out? Just move out. And then there's got to be some corresponding, and maybe we're here, right? So the willingness to get in behind has to be met with a willingness to clear space. You follow me? If I come in here, come and get it, boys. Yeah, I play there, and you suck. Maybe I just drop out. So I don't achieve the goal of getting into the other space, but what have I got? Still got the ball, right? Okay, and play. Let's go. Good, and hold it, boys. Excellent. That's a great picture, and you did it very quickly. Gray's in, three oranges out. Quickly. Yeah. We'll keep. You want to sub in? Do it if you want to sub in. So I think very quickly we got some interesting pictures. Instead of five guys fairly static, maintaining a numerical advantage, we encouraged them to challenge themselves to get into different spaces, and we suggested at least some different ways of doing it. Maybe now we would go to 5v3, but we'll just stay with 5v2. Work it out. You're serving if I need you. Do I need one more orange? Yeah. Okay, and play. Let's go. Oh, orange stayed in. You rascals. Okay, play. Okay, put it in. Okay, don't just kick it out, Gray. Try and complete a pass to your player. Okay, and we play. So coaches, what we'd be looking for is give and goes, movement off the ball, maybe the overlap, maybe a 1v1 breakdown, possibly even a longer ball, and then a movement off like that. And it's maybe a third pass. Yeah, that was good. So you can start to see patterns establishing here. The thing the boys struggle with a little bit is perhaps complementary movement. So they end up... Good. All right. Guys, be aware of the space that you're killing for each other with just moving for the sake of it. All right. Make sure when you move, you pull somebody out or push somebody in. Okay? And play. Okay. Heads up. One more. One more, and we're good. Okay. And we'll call it there. So that's the first activity. Boys, let's take those two cones back two steps. Take this one back two steps for me. Excellent. We'll keep the same 10 guys on the field, but I'll have one gray on that sideline, one gray on this sideline, one orange on that sideline, and one orange on this sideline. So you're in big game. Can I see a ball? Okay, so we're going directional now, coaches. The gray team, your mission is to get it to him or to him, back and forth across the grid. Oranges, your mission is to go back and forth across the grid. And you guys on the outside can move. Fair enough? If you receive it, you come into the grid and one of the grays will go out for you. So now, on the outside, as I'm receiving it, I'm already preparing to come into the grid. Right, Joe? Yeah? Okay, and play. Let's go. Find a target. Not good enough. Give the ball to Gray, start with it, and we play. Good, find him. Good, in, get in, get in, get in, get in. Okay, gray ball right here. Yep, and play, put it in. Just keep that, good. Hold it. Let's just clean this up. So get one outside. Okay. Let's do this because you guys have already thought about this. If you give it to him, Give it back. Give it to him. Give it back. You don't exchange, because why? It was a support pass, right? You only exchange when you get to the far end. All right, play it in. Let's go. Good, just keep it. Excellent, well done. Great. And in you come. Quick, quick, quick. Okay, and hold it there, boys. Excellent, good. That's a good picture, well done. So coaches now, as we watch a little bit, what we're interested in is the movement into the field of play. We're also interested that if you give it to him, is where are you going to bring it into the field of play? Go on, bring it in. Bring it in. Good. And so where is the corresponding, keep the ball. Where's the corresponding movement? So who's out? Big run in behind there. And where are you going now? Well, you got him there. So that's cool for a pass. He's coming into this space. So maybe you just clear out. So we're now looking for the movement of the player that receives it into the grid, corresponding movement the other way, and then what the other two do to assist. Because you've gone there, and because you've gone there, what could you do right away right now? Just hit him right away, because they've pulled the oranges. I see the ball. And we're live. Play. Let's go. Leave it. Gray ball right here. And we play. Okay, and hold it there. Courtney, stop tackling the players. That's good, and hold it there. Now, this is going to be really important when we go to the big goal. Oranges, where's the ball right now? Where's the ball? Oranges. Right there. Where do you want to go with it? Right there. You can't do it right now. So can we get ourselves positioned and with our head looking, so there's there and there's there. If you get in here, what are you aware of? What are you thinking about now? Yeah, but what's the problem with going to him? You're maybe killing that channel, right? So you've got to communicate from back to front. You've got to have your heads on a swivel about where you want to go. You follow me? Because it's going to be really important that we, as we move in and move out, we're clearing space to go to our objective, our target. Let's see the ball. Okay, play it in. Let's go. Yeah, be support. Bring it in. Good, well done. One of the challenges for the boys, and you'll see it, is they're not comfortable bringing the ball in and carrying it into the field of play. They want to pass it right away, and they don't need to a lot of the time. So this is, I think, perhaps a challenge of playing too many keep away games just for the sake of possession, when maybe we want them actually to maintain the ball and feel comfortable. Fellas, when it comes to you on the outside and you come in, see if you can dribble it in, carry it in, all right? And commit a defender and play. Let's go. Good, be support. Be support. Okay. You got another one? Gray ball, give it to the outside and play. Good, Scott. Well done. Okay, Scott, I like at least the willingness to bring it in and take somebody on, so that's good. And play. Well done. In you come, big guy. Yeah, you move it. Find it. Well done. I like the idea. Give the ball to Orange, even though Gray had a good idea. And we play. Yeah. Good. And hold it there. Excellent. So, you two guys, what's your name? And what's his name? You don't know. Go get the ball back there for me. Come in the field of play for a second and just give me the ball. You're out. Okay? So what I particularly like there, and I think it's important to appreciate, you step in and you step out for me, would you? Okay. When he came in now, what was really nice was you two didn't freeze and wait for him and then get stuck standing, right? So I think it's important. As we come in here and he commits, what are you going to do? What are you thinking about doing? All right, you want to check in there for space. So as he commits in here, you're going to flare out and offer there. What are you thinking about doing? You want to go over there? Go on then. Make the move. All right, I like that. That's fine. And so hold it. Give the ball back. And then if that movement's happening there, what's your movement? You want to be behind him? That might be good, right? So we get a little bit. So now his vision becomes here, here, and there, and all things are happening. And so oranges, what's critical is when one guy carries it in, the other two guys can't switch off. You've got to stay awake to the possibilities. You cool? All right, back out there. Live off my touch, and we play. Go on. Yeah, take him on. We'll take it. Good. Yes, get out. Put it in orange. Yes, get the ball. Good. Bring it in. Play, 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 play. Okay, good. All right, excellent. So we'll just hold it there a second. So coaches, first activity, second activity. We've gone to direction, but we're interested in the types of movement, and importantly, for want of a better expression, complementary movement. If one moves here, does one move there? So we don't get our players overly packed on each other, and critically, we don't get them stationary. So what's very important is that we're always seeing some form of movement, and the boys got kind of freed up into it, so that was great. Fellas, two goalies in the goal, and we need all of the balls in the goal, and all the players out. Courtney, can you pick up the blue dots and the double dots for me? Can you pick those double ups? Okay, could I get an orange center back right here? Orange defender. Big burly defender as they come. Big and burly as they come. Who's up? Yeah? Right here, big guy. Right here. And a striker. And a striker? Yeah, stand right in front of him for me so I can see you. A gray center back and an orange attacker. All right, and then the rest of the oranges. There's what, five of you? Three on that dot. That yellow dot, and two on that yellow dot over there on the side. Go stand on the cameraman. Three greys up there, two greys up there, or vice versa. And greys, you're attacking this way, correct? Yeah? Good. Keepers, can you hear me okay? So, if I can get a ball keep, the ball has gone from this keeper to two greys. There's one there, come into the field. Come into the field. One gray here. And we will start with one orange defender. And you're one back in that grid. Right? So you've got that whole space to yourself with just him. You with me? So you two are playing every session in that grid. You two are playing every session in that grid. But this is the temporary thing. So you two attack him. And you've got one as your attacker. And you've got one defender there. Young man, you're just out. There you go. Okay, so we'll go two and one and one and one. So we'll go three versus two to goal, and we'll try and get a shot off or some finish. When the ball is dead, you will leave the field. One of you two will leave the field, and the goalie, you'll distribute to your guys. Okay? So if we just play it through, just walk it through. Walk it through, walk it through. Take a shot. Take a shot for me. Okay. The orange off, one gray off. And one stay, and then play it to the oranges. Let's go. We'll give that offside because it was offside. Okay, put the ball in. Keeper, let's go. Okay, one off on each team and one go into defense, play it to orange, let's go. Okay, bring the ball into the field. Go on, good lad. Okay, Joe, a very aggressive overlap. We'll take it, that's all right, let's go. Okay, that one's dead. Play another one, keep. And hold it there a second. Hold it there. So, perfect. So we'll just stop at this picture. So, what we've got to think about is this. Give him the ball. And in this case, you came in a little bit, but not too far in. And you came in too. So now we've narrowed the field. So for me right now, I just stay out here. Just stay a little bit wider. And maybe an attractive pass. So just step back a little bit, because I think he rolls it across you, you go to goal. I'd like you to engage in moving him around or moving yourself around before he even receives the ball. Okay? So, give me the ball a sec. Just back up. Why don't you pick him up? Go mark him. So you're the tacker and you're going to mark him. All right? Can you take him on a walk that way? Will he go with you? Go on, see if he'll go with you. He didn't want to go with you, but he's a bit confused, so now there's more space here perhaps, right? Can you run behind him and get in here and show two, and now he picks you up, and now we're free here. So your level of engagement to him, it may be that you back him up and get the ball driven into your feet, all right? Typically now, this guy's come at you. Could we maybe take him to the outside, get him even further across, and bring this guy in? So a number of different opportunities, all right? And we play. Let's go. Take him on. Good, and where are you moving? All right, we'll take it. Keeper played into Gray, and we go. Yeah, you can give him a round of applause for a goal.
I'm here, yep.
That would be offside as well. Okay, good save, keeper. Play it to orange, let's go. Okay, great finish, well done. Good job. Yeah, give him a little round. Big guy, what's your name?
Sean.
So Sean's doing something, one, that I like. So just come back in here with me, Sean. Which is now quite popular in the modern game at a high level, but it's not bad at a youth level too, is getting into an offside position and then popping up prior to the ball being delivered, right? So I like that idea because it's a nightmare for him. Why don't you come and mark him? You don't want to give up that much space, right? But now you've got to pay attention to him. So this isn't a bad place to be sometimes, right? Another thing we can do, though, too, is Velcro and actually pick him up and see if you can make him move with you intentionally. You see what I'm saying? So just keep moving that around. Juan, I like the effort. Okay, it's good. Be aware that if you check to them, you're going to get balls driven into your feet, all right? So you've either got to be real sensitive to be moving when they drive it into you. Okay, which way are we going? Yeah, play it. Let's go. All right, not bad. An orange. Let's go. That's good. Well done. And we play. Go on. Now, coaches, just real quick, I'm intentionally, for the purposes of the training session, coaching both teams. I would highly recommend in your environment, you focus on the work of one or the other. I'd let you play the entire game, but just focus on Juan and the Greys, or just focus on Sean and the Oranges. But right now, we're good. Now, let's give it to Gray, give it to Orange for me. Okay. Drive out a little bit. Now, come real aggressive, Sean. Here, good, and hold it. Now, if it goes in, Yeah. And we've got good possession here. Where's your movement? Yeah, we can start thinking about getting across and behind Sean. And you can even stay there for support. Because if Sean receives it here, and you both run beyond him, he's got to turn by himself or start bringing in players we don't have right now. So occasionally, if we check hard to the ball, Juan or Sean, can we get this diagonal run in behind? And then can we see if we can find it? All right, back in, Sean. Show me that aggressive run. And Joe, see whatever space is created and see if you can fill it and see if we can get it. Sean, it may be that you go back to him because the pressure is good. Back to him. It may be that you turn because the pressure isn't good. It may be you just let it run to Joe running in. You've got to decide. But I want that aggressive check to the ball, okay? And we play. Let's go. Okay, I like the idea of the movement. A bit choreographed, but I like the idea. And we'll see if we can find it again. Play. Good finish. Well done. And we go the other way. Well done. Good finish. And we play Gray. Good. And set it up for Orange, and I just want to talk to the crowd. So coaches, I was somewhat sensitive to the space we were going to have in advance. So if you think about it, the width of these wide players is only 30-some yards. So they're well within the width of the penalty box. So these are not wingers for the purposes of this activity. They are withdrawn strikers or forwards. And so what we're starting to build up here is 20 yards. By the time they get the ball, they're here. So it's only about 30 yards away from goal, 30 yards in. So you kind of see the relative space we're trying to explore. And we're trying to explore what Sean and Juan do because we're playing with one striker. You may play with two strikers. So if you have enough players, have two in here. And then it's the relationship of Sean to the other player that becomes important to you. The other thing we might do is give me a gray. Okay, give me one orange in here. One more orange in here. Okay, and play it to the orange. And two come in. Two come in. One there and one there. So now we've got a 3-2 here and a 1-1 here. So you can juggle the numbers around for the picture. But it's pretty tight for the boys. So check out. Check back for me. And we'll just do a couple more of these 2v1s for the benefit of the crowd. Okay, can I see the ball here? But I'd like to see if you guys can read Sean's movement that lets you in behind, or Sean's movement that makes you stay out, and just show me some shapes and patterns that come off of this, because you've got that numerical advantage all the time. All right, and we're playing. Let's go. Okay, very good. And we'll play again, Gray. Juan, take him away now. Be active now. Be active now. There you go. Okay, quicker decision there, right? Give it to the keeper and we'll play. So Juan, once you got in his way, you got to find a way to get out again, all right? And we play. Can you get it? Okay, very good. The trouble with one striker is that if Sean gets all the way in, he becomes another one of your line of three. Right, so be aware of getting in behind Sean if we can, yeah? And if Juan, if you get in here, then the Greys, you've got to be aware that he's in your line and maybe one of you's got to free up beyond, all right? And we play, let's go. Can you find the target? And I think if you're watching, coaches, you'll agree with me that the orange team seems to maintain a 3-2. And the grey team seems to be ending up in a 2v2 all the time and kind of losing a player. So we might need to just look at this team a little bit more. Yes, Sean. Good lad. Okay, that's good. Keeper, play one in. Decide who's out. Okay, good. And hold it there, fellas. Let's all step into here for me. Actually, no, let's do this. Juan, you stay out there with your marker. Sean, you stay out there with your marker. Give me three greys in here and three oranges, and the rest you just sit by the gentleman with the camera. Okay, so I need three and two sitting. Three and two sitting. Perfect. Okay. And can I see, where's Courtney? Keepers, roll some balls to Courtney, will you? Yep. I see the ball. Court, can I get one? Okay, fellas, this is the activity. The balls will always start from me right now. You three have to get the ball into Juan, and then any one of you can join Juan in a 2v1 to go. Oranges, if you can get the ball and get it into Sean, and then you can join Sean, any one of you, in a 2v1 to go. All right? Well, I think we'll play with three for now. We may add a player. Sean, you cannot come in here. All right? We'll play off sides as well. So, Gray defender, if you want to jam him up to the line, I'm okay with that for now. All right? So, Sean and his defender, you're always in there. Keepers, you're going to be looking at 2v1s coming at you. You with me? And we play. Let's go. Sean, you got to stay in there. Oh, well done, Juan. Excellent job. Great finish. Good. Can I see a ball? Juan, well done. Good decisive striker play. That's excellent. Coaches, real quick, just from a pure method thing, if you're concerned about this in here, you could add a neutral player. Yep. So you could have a different colored shirt. Bob Gansler would say there are no neutral players, so he might have a 4-3 overload. So oranges always had four. And just see if that changed the game in favor of oranges because they could find the player. Another thing you could consider doing is allowing the players to use the center back as a support player and Sean can't defend him and Juan can't defend him in possession. So they have a numerical advantage in the back and they can play backwards to come back into the grid. A couple of ways you could solve this if you think this is too much of a cluster, but you guys are doing fine. 3v3, you got a lot of space. You should be able to find your targets, right? When we support Juan, let's be really clear who's going. All right, let's be really clear who's going. So Juan can see the picture of developing, where the run's coming from, and he can make the choice of whether he plays it or keeps it. And the same with Sean. I don't want all three of you just running by yourselves. I want you looking around and making runs off of each other and complementary runs. And we play. Step. Was offsides involved there, perhaps? Okay. And we play? Let's go. Go on now. You got quick because you got one up. Juan, brilliant. You're coming into your own. Well done. You didn't help him out a lot by just standing in an offside position, right? Give a ball into Gray. Give a ball into Gray. Yeah, into Gray. Good. So, Juan, come in here with this player for me. And just mark him a little bit for me. All right? So, what we'd like to do up here is this striker, if you guys are paying a little bit of attention, is where would you play it to Juan right now? In here, right? The foot away from the opponent. And then, Juan, what's your choices from here? By yourself, you bring it across in that way, or you bring it out this way, right? And then obviously runs are coming off of it. So think about where you play it to him, all right? Now, if you don't want to receive the ball with your back to goal, how might you solve the problem? Okay, check out there. I'm all right with that. Come back in here. Do this for me. Just play it into Juan and support there. Yeah, drop it to him, Juan. And then loop it out this way, all right, where you stay on side and he can roll the ball across the front of you if he wants to. See what I'm saying? So Juan, just one more time, I'll show you the movement. Play it in here. Okay, so this is probably the right, correct foot. It's there, Juan, and then the decision is whatever he makes the decision. You with me? And Sean, the same idea of peeling off of that player and getting face to goal without necessarily having to turn yourself. Okay? Yeah. All right, can I see a ball? Keeper. Good, good lad. And we're playing. Let's go. Find him. Find Sean. Okay, leave that one. We got ball here. If Juan checks to the ball and you find him, Juan, you can give it back to them, right? So, just a picture here. You ready to get on your bike? You ready to move? Yeah, so come in here with the ball. So let's say as this goes through to Juan, you check to get it back. So play it in, play it back to him. Yeah, and where's the... No, Juan, play it to the gray. So right in here. Yeah, you ready? So it looks like this. It comes in, it comes back, and then it's just played into the space for the round from behind, from like an overlapping fullback almost. You follow me? So there's patterns we can get into that are not just whacking into Sean and support him. All right. Are we live? And we're playing. Let's go. Find him. I'll take it. Good effort, keeper. And we're good? We're playing? Juan, can you come this way, Juan? Okay, excellent. Set it up again. Hold the ball for me, Court. So, just one thing, coaches, that I'm a bit concerned about, and this would be a concern if you're Fernando Torres at Chelsea and other people, is that you three in here don't seem to pay much attention to Juan until it's obvious, and the same for Sean. And Sean, I think you can help them find you a bit more by verbalizing, but also by your movement. So if your movement is sharp, it'll catch their attention. If you talk it through, they'll find you. Same with you, Juan. A bit more personality in helping them find you. Tell them if they're in your passing lane, right? Tell them if you want them to turn. If you make a sharp movement, tell them that's where you want the ball or you're clearing space. You follow me? I need that engagement. Okay, and we play. Let's go. Good. All right. Let's you two tag anybody out except for Juan, and you two tag anybody out except for Sean and Juan. I want Sean and Juan on the field. All right. Everybody into the grid. Inside now. Juan inside. So where we take this game now, coaches, bear in mind again, if you want to play with two strikers, make this a 2v2 in here. That's totally fine. So it's again exploring ways that this might help you and work for you in your environment. Certainly, with boys this age, we honor offsides. And it is quite challenging if they're intelligent defenders because they can really jam the field. But the boys did some okay things with it. All right, now we're gonna play the same activity. Keepers, it's gonna be a 1v nobody versus you. Or just no defender, it's just gonna be one guy coming in. One guy coming in, all right? But it must go through Sean or Juan first. So it's got to hit them. And can I see a ball, Court? So if I hit Juan right, just back it onto the line, Juan. You've got to stay in the grid, but right there and hold it. What's a pretty smart thing for Juan to do right now? Just spin and go, right, Juan? You with me? Or it may be you have to drop it and it gets dropped in here and we release you in on the other side. So there's a number of different ways to do it. Okay, it might be Juan just post him up one. That if I drive it in, you can just flick it into that space, or drop it, or spin yourself. So it's any number of different ways to get in. 1v nobody, quick fast break. Has to go through Juan or Sean. We cool? All right, so it's gonna be much more congested in here, but you've got to remember who you're trying to get it to, and then you've got to remember to try to be available, because it's all off of you. You're the superstar here. Okay, and we play. Let's go. Can you get in? There, go. Court, can I see a ball? All right, well done. Great, fantastic. And we play. I'll take it, Sean. That's all right. Good. All right, can I see a ball? Maybe two. Okay, heads up. You're going to get back in? And we play. Find one if you can.
Yeah, again, see.
That's just kind of a counter-attack, but we'll give it to you, Sean, because you seem like a nice lad. Okay, and we play.
One ball. Yes, you stay up. Yeah, that one.
Good play. Push on.
Okay, just roll the ball in there, keeper. Good, thanks, Courtney. Appreciate it. Okay, Sean, get high for me. Okay, now, in the case of Gray, Juan is staying pretty high and central, which is fine, but Juan, it becomes increasingly predictable for the oranges where you are. So you're going to mix it up a little bit. Sean checks in here a lot, so just check in for me, Sean, and get the ball. All right? Now, I'm happy if the movement is just right in behind him like that. I'm okay with that. But maybe the movement could come in this way across him, right? So if you come across here now and hold it, if the ball goes there, that's an interesting ball for you to run through to, yeah? And maybe if you make the diagonal run, give it back to him, make the diagonal run, what are you gonna do? Go make it, just move and take him with it. Take, go Gray, go on, go. Diagonal. So where's the pass now? Yeah, it's on the other side. So Sean's willingness to check in creates space in behind. And it doesn't always have to be a straight line. It could be a diagonal across the back to receive it or to release a guy in. You follow me? Okay, Juan, we good? And we're fine. Let's go. Excellent. Can I see the ball? Okay, one defender can track back in now. So you can't just play lazy balls in. It's got to be a real crisp ball because goalies, you're going to get one defender track for you. And we play. Well done. That's good. That's fine defending. That's all right. So oranges, you're going to have to work a bit harder now. That's out of bounds, Sean. They played you in the zone. Now, Sean, you're doing a great job of checking in, but you're doing it all the time. So hold it sometime, Sean, and play. Okay, put it in, keep. All right, that one's dead. We'll play from here. Just roll it. We'll play from here. And play. And hold it. All right, hold it there. So this is the problem now, boys. Stay where you are. If I was really believing that Sean ran across, you ran across, and you stayed wide, all with the purpose of spreading, getting him in, I'd give you high grade, but that isn't what happened. So Sean gets in, you've run 100 miles across the field, haven't you? He's just got frozen, and then they're getting closer and closer to you. You see a space, but this is not good. So Sean, get back up in here, get back to where you were, because I like where you were. You get out there, all right, back up for me, and back up where you were a little bit. So Sean, you check down, right? You get in behind, maybe you release here, and where could you go now? Well, maybe just flare out here. Because what might, look what's happening. So now he's freed up, right? If that run, he picks him up, now you're just going to get the ball and you'll be faced up and you're going too. Do you see what I'm saying? So this is the notion, boys, of pulling and pushing each other around. Sean pulls here, you go behind, you check down, you release. That's exciting. Because that's four or five guys in a very tight attacking space, and you're going to really move the oranges around, the greys around. Back it up, Sean. Get out wide. Okay. You're going to find Sean as he checks to, and we're just going to play. Right, play. Let's go. We're live. All right, not bad. Excellent. And play to a grey, and we go. Okay, I'll see the ball. I'll see it. Yep. Turn. That's out of bounds. We're good. See it, Sean? Yep. Good enough. Well done. All right, fellas, last one. Just pick the yellows up and bring them to this sideline. Just bring them across. You see a ball caught. Good, just drop them down. So Juan's going to play high, Sean's going to play high, and we've got sort of three midfielders, but kind of like three forwards behind Sean, three forwards behind Juan. Offsides apply. I've got 250 linesmen there and 250 linesmen there, and we'll play 2 minutes. If the ball goes out of bounds, Courtney and I will start it. All right, free play. Free play. If you don't want to play it to Juan or Sean, I'm totally happy with that. And play. Let's go. I've got a ball. Okay, ball's right here. Ball's right here. And play. Good, Sean. Sean, I like the way you just turned the corner with it. That's fine, Sean, that's fine. And we're playing. Let's see the ball. Oh, Sean. Sean, that's great stuff. Well done. Keeper, you start with it. Good, and hold it there. So we're only 1 minute into 2 minutes. So coaches, if you observe, just for the last minute and a half, what I would argue is the boys are not now just running up and down or just running anywhere. There is some, in possession, there is some logic, increasing logic to their movement, and they're aware of some of the spaces that we've developed over the last 40 minutes. So I'm starting to see some actual attacking patterns now, and they're freelancing them and improvising them, because they're empowered and they're free in this environment. So we'll play one more minute. Let's go. Well done, Juan, well done. And put it in for Orange. Hey, Sean, go see how far you can get. Start again. You can start again. Okay, don't be afraid to start again. And we play. Okay, now you got to look at him and work out what he wants, yeah? He didn't want to be put in a foot race down the field. Grey ball. Excellent run. That attack had some merit, I would think. Oh, unlucky one. Good effort. One last one from Orange. See if we can get to goal. Can we get to goal? Sean, take him away. Yeah. You can get behind Sean. Hello. All right, and we'll take it there. Hold it. Great job. That was a nice attack at both ends to finish. Come with me. So this is a really willing and very nice group of players from FC Continental. So please give them one round of applause again. It's like an old vaudeville routine. It's the talent and then the lovely assistant, Courtney. But thank you, Courtney. So coaches, just briefly, a progressive training session, 5 activities, a warm-up, possession activity with a purpose, directional, the counter-attack wing play game to a zonal game, to a compact zonal game, and then obviously finish with an open scrimmage. I think in 55 minutes, we created some pictures. We talked about some things that we would then want to talk about for the next 16 weeks of the season at different times and explore what we would get from Sean, what we would get from Juan, what we would get off of them, what would we get if we changed to playing 2 and experiment with 2. But I think something like this brought into the program on a consistent basis would elevate potentially the performance of your team. Thank you very much for your attendance, and thank you for the FC Continental. That's good. Give me a little love.
Thank you.